Bookish friends, welcome to another installment of Turkish Shelf. Today I'm going to talk about the Turkish modern classic Kürk Mantolu Madonna by Sabahattin Ali, which was published in English as Madonna in a Fur Coat, which is the exact translation of the Turkish original title. Sabahattin Ali was born in Edirne in 1907. When he was a student, he wrote many short stories and poems and tried to get them published in the literary magazines with the help of his literature teacher. He then studied to become a teacher and started to work in a school in Yozgat, which is a neighboring city of the capital, Ankara. He married in 1935 and he had one daughter. Because he worked in a political humor magazine, he was jailed for some time for ridiculing the political figures. Because he was censored by the government, he tried to escape Turkey, but then killed by a smuggler who was paid by the author and promised him escape in 1948. In his short life of 41 years, he wrote 5 short story collections and 3 novels. His novels are titled Kuyucaklı Yusuf, which can be translated as Yusuf from Kuyucak, İçimizdeki Şeytan, The Devil Inside Us, and Kürk Mantolu Madonna, which is, as I've said before, is translated as Madonna in a Fur Coat, between the years of 1935 and 1943. The story takes place in the years between the years of 1918 in Berlin, and another timeline is set in Ankara in 1935. Our narrator, Rasim, visits his work colleague, Raif, whom he shares the same room, when he hears that he is ill. When Raif's condition gets worse, Raif gives his notebook to Rasim and asks him to burn it in a stove. Rasim wonders about the contents of the notebook and discovers an old bittersweet love story through Raif's diary. The title of the book is taken from a name of the picture, Madonna in a Fur Coat. There is a passage in the book which describes the theme of the book very well. Although I have read the book in Turkish, I have looked at the translated ebook version as well, and saw that it was translated very accurately, so I want to read that passage. It is perhaps easier to dismiss a man whose face gives no indication of an inner life. And what a pity that is. A dash of curiosity is all it takes to stumble upon treasures we never expected. As indicated in this paragraph, the main theme of the novel is that the people who think as very boring can have a complex and sensitive soul if you do not look closely at their souls. It's true, isn't it? As for the characters, we have 3 distinctive characters in this book. One of them is Raif, who had a bittersweet love story in his past. He is our main hero. He belongs to a family in the southeast region in Turkey. He grows up as a lonely child who likes to read and draw. He tries to finish fine arts, but he cannot. He then goes to Berlin to become a soap maker. He meets the love of his life there. And after coming back to Turkey, he marries and has children. As for his personality traits, he is sensitive, usually quiet, calm, and minds his own business, and has really good work ethics. He is stoic and he does not like to reflect his problems to anyone, but that is actually related to a secret love that he still pines after. The second character in the book is Rasim, who is our narrator. He's about 25 years old in the later timeline of 1935. He was raised in Ankara, the capital city of Turkey. He's very interested in art and sees money only as a means to live a better and more educated life. And our third character is Maria Puder. She is Raif's beautiful former girlfriend in Berlin. She is Jewish and feels like a stranger in 1920s Berlin. She works as a singer in a mediocre level nightclub. She is a strong woman who tries to live her life to the fullest, even if she does not have money and struggling to survive. In other words, she is the Madonna in the fur coat. And how did I feel about them? I think I liked Maria Puder the most because she was the one who really knew what she wanted. And I always admire strong women in the novels, and that's why she was my favorite among those three main characters. Madonna in a Fur Coat was published in Hakikat newspaper between the dates of December 1940 and February 1941 in 48 parts, and then it was published as a novel in 1943. It is rumored that Sabahattin Ali had a lover when he stayed in Germany, and the story is based on this former love story. It is considered the earlier and the best examples of psychological novel in Turkish, but it was banned in Turkey for a very long time because of the author's political views. Right now, this novel is very beloved among the Turkish readers and still remains one of the best-selling modern classic novels. You can see this book in every bookshop in Turkey. I gave this book 4 stars. I enjoyed the writing style very, very much. It was very easy to read, and it really felt like I was reading a fairy tale-esque type of book. And like in English, of course, I admire a good wording structure in Turkish as well, and it was published originally in 1940 and 1941. It feels like a modern work of literature because of its really successful writing style and wording. For the plot, I liked the plot, but I didn't love it because especially the later timeline was a bit depressive as regards to the former timeline, in which the love story is told in a very fairy tale-esque way, as I've said before. I had trouble connecting with the later timeline in 1935, and because I do not want to give spoilers, I will not go into details. I have a hard time having sympathy towards characters who suffer the consequences of their free will choices. I wish I could have gone into more details, but that's all I'm going to say about this book. But I can understand why it is such a beloved classic. Unfortunately, in Turkish literature, there is a trend of writing lonely characters, and writing about happiness is not considered as literary as writing about loneliness and depression. But because of his writing style, I like this book very much, and as I've said before, I gave it 4 stars. The fact that he wrote so beautifully about the happy times made me want to read more books from Sabahattin Ali. In this installment of Turkish Shelf, I try to evaluate a Turkish modern classic. And a very beloved book in the Turkish reading community. So please comment down below if you have a book that is written by a Turkish author and would like to know what I think about it. I would gladly read that book and do a Turkish Shelf review video on that book. I would be very glad to help you decide if you want to read that book or not. And also, please like and subscribe. Hope to see you very soon. Bye! For Turkish Turkish word of the day, since the title of the book was Madonna in a fur coat, I thought fur should be the Turkish word of the day. Fur means kürk in Turkish, and kürk is our Turkish word of the day. Have a good day!